ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم ألا تعبدوا الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين وأن اعبدوني هذا صراط مستقيم ولقد أضل منكم جبلا كثيرا أفلم تكونوا تعقلون هذه جهنم التي كنتم
توعدون. We have the idea that we are self-sufficient. We are forgetting about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The busy pace of this dunya, working, making money, having a good degree, making a lot of money, makes us forget that this is only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi al-Azim, brothers and sisters, often that we go to the supermarket, how many of us ponder and we go to the, for example, the fruit and the vegetable section, and we go and we buy things, we take the lime, we take the orange, we take the tomatoes, we take everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us in the bag. How many of us contemplate, where did this come from? Where did this come from? Did the supermarket produce this? We forget, because we do not plant anymore. We do not take our eggs from the chicken ourselves anymore. We just go take it from the shelves so that we forget where these things come from. And the only thing that we remember is our money got us these things. Our money got us these things. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stopped the rain for just a couple of months, we will not be able to survive. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had a massive disease go on the earth and kills all the vegetation and everything is in it, we will not be able to survive. So be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you, and just be grateful to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the main principle of Islam, what Islam means. This is what Islam makes it different. So this is the main thing what Islam is. What Islam and what worship is. This is what you worship. So regardless if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what do you worship? What is the motive that you do in this dunya? Is the motive to make more money? Then you are worshipping money. By worshipping money, you are worshipping the shaitan. So it's either two choices that you have. You're worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or you're worshipping the shaitan. What is the motive that you do things? Are your motive that you're doing these things to seek a girl? Is that what your motive is? Because it's just for lust? And this is what your worship is towards. That's what you're worshipping. There is many of us as human beings that we worship women, money, power. We worship all these things. We worship all these things. There's a story of the Umar ibn Khattab, radiallahu anhu, very beautiful story. Umar ibn Khattab, and it shows you how, what it mean, really means to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The beautiful character of our leaders before. Because if we really have characters like this, and we have leaders like this, then you understand what peaceful this world is. Umar ibn Khattab, one day he stood up to the believers when he was a Khalifa. When he was a Khalifa, he stood up and he wanted to say something to them, a lecture to them. So he said, "Asma'u wa ati'u." He says, listen and obey. And one of the people there, one of the Muslim people stood up and says, we will not listen or obey. And he told him why, because at that time there was some cloth that came from different places that was given to the Muslims at the tribe at that time. Pieces of cloth. And Umar ibn Khattab had gave every person that is living in that time, he gave him a piece of cloth. But when he got up to say the sermon and to speak to the people, he was wearing two pieces. He was wearing two pieces, but he gave everybody one. So that person says, we will not listen or obey. Just for the reason is that you are wearing two pieces and you gave us one piece. So therefore you are being unjust, even though he was the ruler of the whole land, the Khalifa. This is shows you how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how just you have been to be in the tea in order for him to be, for what you do is a worship. What did Umar ibn Khattab says? He says, call over my son. So his son comes and he says, talk to these people and tell them, why do I have two pieces of cloth? And he told the people, my father is at a big belt and high stature. He is very big built. He needs two pieces of cloth to cover himself. I gave him my piece of cloth so he could have two pieces of cloth. He even though he was big belt, he did not take two pieces of cloth. His son gave him his piece of cloth to have two pieces of cloth so he could cover himself. And this is how we should live our life. This is what it means to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this is the example of Umar ibn Khattab, that his power and his position did not compromise the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He did not get deluded by his position. His position does not mean that he could have the highest end of things, as our leaders have today. It does not mean that they could drive the best Mercedes and the best things and the best castles, and they have castles underwater and over water, over mountains, and they have everything they want. This is not what it means of power. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put you in power to serve His law, to be just. Just like the person that has nothing, he deserves to have what you have. This is what Islam is, and worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must have this idea in our normal lives. We must see that. Is this happening in our normal life? This is what we're doing with our wife and children. Because whatever we do with our family is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, will let our leaders do to us. So if we feel our leaders are unjust to us, because we are unjust to our families. We are unjust to our women. We are unjust to the weakest of the believers. So if you want to change our condition, do not attack the higher level. Go back down and fix what's down there. You cannot say these people are unjust and you're unjust on yourself. If we understand that, brothers and sisters, then that's what we could change the world from now on. There is no point of crying and complaining how the world is unjust. Because we are a big part of the reason why the world is like this today. If we wake up and realize that, just how like this, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam alerted people and they all woke up, then we will be successful how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العلي العظيم لي ولكم استغفروه الغفور الرحيم.